All right, so I just want to tell you a little bit about the show to give you a context. It's basically set during the Spanish, or kind of set during the Spanish Civil War. The play is comprised of three different units, in a way. The first is the realism of the war itself, where we have the fascists and the rebels fighting against each other. The second is the unit of the population and how... and how various populations are affected by war. It uses a form of theater of the absurd, which is a form that was developed post-World War II, which uses extreme and sometimes grotesque stylized characters to really comment on thematic experiences like othering, mob mentalities, etc. That's another section of the world. And the third section of the world is the world of fairy tale, which surrounds a young girl who is in the throes of this war, and it's her way of navigating that experience. The play is a construct, so it's an adaptation and inspired by about 12 different text sources, including Pan's Labyrinth, For Whom the Bell Tolls, Hemingway, as well as some real-life testimonials from survivors or from letters that were written during the Spanish Civil War. A lot of people don't realize over 100,000 people still missing, still unmarked, and those records still sealed. The play overall was inspired by the unexpected passing of a student at TFS, and really it's a little bit of a love song and a tribute to them. There are some trigger warnings, that being said, given that it is set in this time period. So, of course, violence certainly is an issue. There are real-looking weapons on the stage. I will assure you they are made of rubber and plastic. They do not contain any ability to actually carry any type of actual bullets, et cetera, et cetera. But there's definitely violence and weaponry. There's war imagery. There's some cursing that might happen, and certainly all forms of threat do exist in this world. I think that's all I need to say, and I will say thank you all for coming. I'm very grateful. I'd like to just mention thank you to Sammy, who is the stage manager on the show.
Spain, 1944. The Civil War is over. Hidden in the mountains, armed men fight the new fascist regime. Military posts are established to exterminate the resistance. In this town, a disease is raging. A battle of ideologies with left and right locked in battle. But death rules supreme. Dying is only bad when it takes a long time and hurts so much that it humiliates you. So this war created a death that only takes a moment.
22 squabbling over petty nonsense. Knowledge is power, so let us know what to do.
Yeah, precisely! Knowledge and power are two of the faculties of the human spirit.
My hypothesis is those people live in total confusion. No morals, no traditions. In fact, they say that's what they die from, confusion.
You gotta do what you gotta do, eh?
If you make a disturbance here, you will be hunted straight out of this town. It is only by doing nothing here that we're able to live here. It is the principle of the fox.
Yes, it is the principle of the fox. We need the wolf.
You should not speak that aloud. One never knows where one stands, either to the left or to the right. One never knows.
I am a warthog woman who shall live until I die.
The animal has more liberty than the cat, but it varies the best it makes. The cat is the best anarchist.
Sunday is my turn to push the carriage. I've got the twins. My wife stays home, but let's!
With me, it's just the opposite. Oh, I tell you, I was in rough shape. I felt as though I was stuck in a thick fog. My muscles all tight, my nerves on edge. Well, I was in bad shape, I tell you.
For me, it was much worse. Nervous breakdowns, like the whole world had become a distant planet. Unreal, ice cold, shut tight, something that had become foreign and hostile to me. No communication, cut off. It was me who was shut up and shut out. One wonders how we managed to survive.
It's not always
fun and games, as my friend Franco says.
Maybe we're better off dead.
Don't say that! You'll bring bad luck!
What more can we know about the moral scheme of things? The politicians only show us what they show us, and so we cannot know one league more. It's the old picture that counts. The rest is nothing.
Nothing doesn't add up to much, that's true. But I prefer the view of the right. The right can't be wrong after all, can it?
I can't be sure if the right is right, because we're all up on the hillside, while we are down in the valleys. And how can you say which is better if the best of you from up there?
Do what you're asked to do with some things they ask.
Know something, my friend. I no longer expect any pleasure from life. I'll settle for neutrality. Sit quietly on the sidelines and watch the show without feeling any pain. Yeah, I'll settle for that.
There is no future.
Nothing is to come yet. Everything is predictable.
It's better to prevent than to cure.
Nothing is preventable.
Nothing is curable.
Not even the curable.
Not even the predictable is preventable.
And in my opinion, the curable is the real poison.
Dear lady and neighbor, would you be kind enough to keep an eye on the babies for a moment?
I haven't seen your twins yet. I hear they are darling.
We'll have a look, just don't wake them up. Me and my friend here are going to be having a drink.
He's going to be having a drink, in fact.
I was told they were blonde, but they don't look very fair-skinned to me.
They do not come any blonder or pinker, madam.
The one on the right looks red and yellow.
The one on the left looks red and black.
Yellow?
Black and red?
They're both ice cold!
They suffocated in each other.
They're the picture of hell. Yes! If they suffocated each other, that means it's somebody else's fault.
Who did it? Who killed my babies?
Who could have done such a thing?
I know who. This morning I left them with her grandmother. She's already resented them because she hates me.
Maybe the father is not good enough reason for killing children.
I can see how someone could do such a thing in a moment of anger.
It is worse than shameful.
There she is! You're the one who killed my baby!
I didn't do it, I swear!
You're murderous!
Hey, take it away!
She's innocent!
Sister! Kill her! Kill her!
Murderer!
Oh, I didn't touch her, okay? She fell by herself.
That was my benefactress! You'll pay for that!
You killed my friend! You rat! You killed her! Kill her!
Thank you. Fellow citizens, an evil has recently contaminated our fair town. It makes a declaration of war against us, seeking to kill us all. But as you see, life goes on, as usual, for many among us, almost happily. People have started dying in houses, in churches, in street corners, in public places. People have just begun to drop dead. And what is worse is that these are isolated cases. A death here or there is something we all can adjust to if necessary. But the deaths are increasing constantly. You may say that in our town there are homes where entire families have disappeared. For a time, you may have thought that the explanation was the revival of old tribal feuds between us, the nationalists, and the republics. I can assure you that we have nothing to do with this, though I do suspect the rebels are behind this, and warn you all to root out their evils. I have gathered you here in our town square one last time to tell you what is happening to us, that we are being devastated by a plague of dissension. I must also advise you that neighboring countries have barred their cities to you. No one is to enter, and none of you may leave. As of today, we are trapped. Fellow citizens, do not attempt to flee. As you will never get past the bullets of the National Guards posted at the entrances and the exits of our town, we must call up the strength of our courage,
yeah!
And the power of our resignation.
Whoa!
Anyone can be a suspect and will be incarcerated. Watch for suspects. Report them to us in the interest of the public. In any case, there shall be no more public meetings. Groups of more than three shall be dispersed. It is also forbidden to loiter. Citizens are requested to move two by two so that one may constantly watch the other. I report at once anyone who says anything questionable. Now go back to your homes and remain there. Do not go out unless it is absolutely necessary. Lord, have mercy on us.
There are no lies of fame beyond the secret revolution. There lived a princess who dreamt of the human world. She dreamt of blue skies, the soft breeze, and sunshine. One day, eluding her keepers, the princess escaped. Once outside, the brightness blinded her and erased her memory. She forgot who she was and where she came from. Her body suffered cold, sickness, and pain. Eventually, she died. Her father, the king, always knew that the princess would return, perhaps in another body, in another place, at another time. And he would wait for her until he drew his last breath, until the world stopped turning. What he couldn't know was that the pain, trauma, and rage surrounding her death was bound to her as deeply as the bullet which had taken her life. It buried itself deep inside her and festered, and within the wounds, the disease grew. And without her knowing, it would spread itself across the land, bathing the world around her in death. Taking revenge on all those who cheered on the murder. This is her story. And the story of a town, a country, but is also a warning.
call to action against hate, fascism, ignorance, and other. This is a love song and a mourning for life lost.
They have too many of them!
Not even a thread should be able to slip through.
Sir, everything is shut tight.
No one is to look at the window either. The mere sight of the evil of this war could contaminate. Go and look, expect everything again. Go on! Pray on! Because evil air can make its way in by magic despite thick walls. Evil spirits can ignore walls and doors.
If you think about it, sir, it can sneak in through your thoughts.
I tell you, you won't get it! Are we impenetrable? Answer!
We are impenetrable!
You say it too!
I'm impenetrable!
And you! I am impenetrable. I am untouchable.
Hulk's hands are turning black.
His eyes are black. His face is yellow.
Is it a symptom of the plague?
Is it the plague?
You cannot leave a house where the sickness has struck. If you try, I will shrill.
Going on in my country. In all these years I've been living in this body, there has been no peace. Ever since my neighbor started disappearing, ever since my father was killed, ever since the bombs began to drop and the bullets began to scream. My mother still has all the hope in her heart, but me, I keep my suitcase back and dream of some place far away from here. I think I brought the war with me unwillingly. If you look deeply inside me, you'll see it. Somewhere between my ribs. Like a big ball of black molasses filled with screams so large it can devastate the world! What do I do? I want to love, but my hair smells like war. And running. And running.
Take their backs to the room.
Yes, sir. You will see. We will be happy here. It's been so long since we've had a house to call our own, to have someone take care of us. Your father is a dutiful man and he will make sure that we want for nothing.
He's not my
Enough! Father. Now listen. Please just do as he says and the right path will be revealed in due time.
Carmen?
This way, honey.
It's a labyrinth. Just a pile of old stones. It's been here since before the town was built. But let's not get too close. We might get lost.
Thank you.
And as for all the books, have you read them all?
Oh, yes.
Captain's calling for you. Stop wasting time with the girl and join us. Immediately.
I must get going. Your father needs me.
He's not my father. The captain? He's not my father.
Well, he is now.
My father was a tailor. He died in the war. I believe they killed him for his beliefs.
Ophelia!
The captain is not my father.
Well, you made that clear enough.
Did you see my mother? She's pretty, isn't she? You saw her belly? That's my baby brother. The captain is his father, but he's making her sick.
Come, we best get inside.
The
first casualty when war comes as truth. I'm tired and sick of war. Its glory is all moonshine. It is only those who have neither fired a shot nor heard the shrieks and groans of the wounded who cry aloud for blood, for vengeance, for desolation. Although it may be necessary at times to defend our people, war is a sickness that must be cured. War is time out of balance. It is a hell where we turn against and away from each other, where everyone is an enemy, and we betray our most basic humanity.
You should be consoled by the thought that this has to end sometime.
There are many dragons we have to face. But what will matter is how to face them. We must accept death that is a part of our lives. We are born alone, and we die alone. But in between, I will fight this power and destroy those tyrants! This government is a ruined apple. Just shake it and see the madness of it. If we don't do something, we are cowards. Or even worse, traitors. We are here to take up arms and destroy this corruption and rid all the casinos.
Is it understandable to want to protect our people? To want social justice, of course. But the question is how to achieve it.
Did he say that Amik shall inherit the earth? But I'm tired of waiting. We stand united in this common purpose, and you will ask yourself, it is all worth it. And you will fill your heart with an answer. Yes. Yes. Hatred of oppression, hatred of tyranny, hatred of those ones who live like animals. Denying our hopes and stealing our lives. Come on, it will be faith. Faith that a new world will burn from the blood and the old. We need courage.
Yes.
To burn from our cages and set ourselves free.
Yes.
To live not as an eagle in flight, or die in the tent.
The captain's men have blocked all entrances to the town. There is no way to enter or to leave.
You are not alone in this. There are many here who have fought with us shoulder to shoulder, whose families have disappeared, been killed, and buried in my streams. The decision to fight only takes a moment, but the consequences of not fighting will last a lifetime mine. All of you! This country will be savaged by those beasts!
As we continue with our mission, we must have health and strength. The captain has told citizens that the plague has struck and that everyone has to stay locked indoors. The patrols roam the streets and kill everyone who moves about beyond curfew.
He uses fear to give them to each other's throats. They say that the greatest means of controlling the citizens is to make them believe that the people are the threat and the cost of those deaths. And so they talk to each other like rodents, clowning their way to the top of the prison of their own making. He becomes their patron saint, and they enter worship at the altar of his lies, and fear mongering. He must break through his lies. He must break through his lies! Because this is the last end! And we are the last great cause!
For now, let us stick to the woods. Mercedes will get us the medicine and supplies we need. She is devoted to you and to our purpose. We are all one, and they cannot take that from us.
We will take everything from them!
The gorillas are sticking close to the woods because it is difficult to track them down up there.
Those pricks know the terrain better than any of us! We need to force them down!
I shall begin by weeding out any allies they may have in our town. Then, I will block their access to medicine and supplies, and I will ensure that all the citizens believe that the rebels are the cause of these deaths in our town.
Good. We will set up 3 command posts. Here, here, and here. All food rationing and medical supplies will be distributed from the main camp and stored under lock with the key next to my barracks. I will be the sole person in possession of the key.
Those bastards are going to starve. I promise you this. I will lead my men to the edge of town and set up traps along all of the entrances.
They're like an infection which needs to be rooted out and destroyed. You truly have a gift. The ability not to ignore but to despise every bad ending they seek to bring to us. For you, failure is not an option. It is simply not a possibility. But you know that death means nothing. But all that truly matters is our great nation.
More than any other time in our history, mankind faces a crossroads. One path leads to despair, utter hopelessness. The other, to total extinction. Let us pray with the wisdom to choose correctly.
Move out! Viva España! Viva el rey! Viva el orden! El orden!
Sit down. The chairs aren't very comfortable.
It will soon be 20 years since we've last seen each other. And here you are, sick.
Not yet dead, however.
I can see that. Working really hard, I've heard. Something important, is it political?
I've read pieces of it. Oh, it's great.
That was a stupid fight.
Just a misunderstanding.
A misunderstanding that deprived me of your friendship for such a long time. But now that I found you again, he would have been easy enough to find earlier. You should have tried.
But Alexandra could have made some just like the words me do.
You would have welcomed it.
Come now. Of course he would have. Come now. Of course he would have.
Is this Trenini's disease?
Somehow this is Tyranny's disease. To trust no facts.
Friendship is much stronger than any theories or principles. You yourself have changed. You have different ideas than what you used to have. Was it the war that changed you with its sickly nationalistic ideals?
Oh, for me, a friend is someone who thinks the same as I do. To remain a friend, he must change his ideas the same time as I do. I am joking, of course, but on the whole, I mean it. I came here to speak with you to make you understand the hidden reason behind our misunderstanding.
Please don't rack your brain about this, and once more, don't rack his. The doctor doesn't want him to get upset. She was very hesitant about allowing your visit at all.
Let's change the subject. I'm glad to see you. Let's talk about nothing.
You see, Alexander is above such things as misunderstanding.
That's absurd.
Oh, is it obvious Alexandra is not a jealous person?
He certainly would never accept your ideals.
I live in an antiseptic world. The sound and the fury of the world outside is greatly toned down by the time it filters through to me. It is no longer frightening, or should I say, disturbing.
Many people are dying these days, one way or another.
Many more than usual.
Though some have strangely disappeared.
I know.
It's quite fashionable.
I've heard about it.
Anyways, you're looking better.
So are you, even though you're roaming the streets all day long.
And it was as of that moment that your attitude changed towards me abruptly. Is that right?
That's right. And then we attach too much importance to things. We must say what we have to say. That way, we'll have at least reserved a place for ourselves in the history of this entanglement.
Do you feel better?
I still have the pain, but it's less acute.
You said you were out of pain!
You can send it. Don't get up. I have a lot of work at the moment. 1,000 people died today in the streets in the same way. Were they individual deaths? Some were individual and others were in groups of 10 or 12.
Perhaps it was the bullet holes.
I hope that didn't hurt too much.
No, I feel much better. Better than I've ever felt before.
You're usually so sensitive about injections.
Well, honestly, though, I'm expecting another truckload any minute.
The numbers get larger every day.
Surely you expect to find a cure and explanation for the sickness.
Is it really a sickness?
My friends!
What did you say?
What did he say?
He said my friends!
Wait, doctor! Look at him! His eyeball!
My friend!
He's fainted!
He's dead!
Impossible! Oh, yes! What am I gonna do with him? I didn't even get to talk to him!
Oh, too late.
Yourself, and you know your enemy. You need not fear the result of 100 battles. If you know yourself, but not your enemy, for every victory gained, you will suffer a defeat. And if you know neither yourself nor your enemy, you will succumb in every battle.
Oh, your feet are as cold as ice, my darling girl? Are you scared?
A little bit. What's that noise?
Nothing. It's just the wind. Nights here are different from city nights. There you hear trains, cars, and you hear the houses are all weird. But don't let your imagination wander too far out of doors.
I tell her that as well.
You're too much like your father, always dreaming of magical worlds and new days. But we're here now. This is our new life. And I need you to celebrate this opportunity with me by my side.
Why did you get married?
We were alone too long.
You weren't alone. You were never alone.
As you get older, you'll understand that in this world, one can never be alone. It hasn't been easy for me. And your father, he placed me under suspicion. I had to take steps to keep us safe.
Wait, Carmen?
It's your brother is acting up. He senses that he's close to his father and he's eager to join us all. Tell him one of your stories. He'll calm down.
You have to get up to the mountain and meet my husband. The leg wound's getting worse.
I'm sorry. This is all I could get for now. The captain turned all the medication and down each vial to ensure all is accounted for.
The captain's downstairs now. Don't keep him waiting. We can't afford suspicion.
There was a magic rose that made whoever plucked it immortal. But no one would dare go near it because its thorns were full of mortal poison. So amongst the men, tales of pain and death were told in hushed voices. There was no talk of eternal life on the left side of the garden, only the here and now. But on the right, because all men feel pain more than they want immortality, they sought to destroy the rose. The rose wilted, unable to bequeath its gift, alone and forgotten at the top of that mountain, alone and forgotten until the end of time, until those who hid beneath the trees found their time.
Doctor, welcome, welcome, come in. The captain expects a full report. We are all very eager to welcome his heir into the New World Order.
How's my wife?
Quite weak.
She'll rest as much as needed. I'll stay down here. Garces and I have business to go over.
Yes, sir.
And my son?
You're the captain. His son. How is his son, the heir to the throne of our great land?
For the moment, there is no reason for alarm. Though she should not have traveled this late in the pregnancy.
Is that your opinion?
Boy must be born wherever his father is.
Yes, sir. One more thing, sir. What makes you so sure it's a boy?
The fucking doctor! That woman can only bear my wishes at command. She can only do what I need her to.
Yes, sir.
Hatred paralyzes life. Love releases it. Hatred confuses life. Love harmonizes it. Hatred darkens life. Love illuminates. And even in the shadow of war, some of us cling to love, for it may just lead to our salvation.
No, I'm...
You are a princess.
daughter of the king of the underworld?
No. My father was a tailor.
You are not born of a man. It was the moon that bore you. Look on your left shoulder. You'll see a mark that proves it. Your real father had us open portals all over the world to ensure your return. This is the last of them. But we have to make sure that your essence is intact, that you have not become mortal and infected in battles between men. To ensure your return, you have 3 tasks to fulfill before the moon is full. This is the Book of Crossroads. Open it when you're alone. It will show you your future, show you what must be done.
But there's nothing here. There's nothing here.
My fellow comrades, we have gathered here today to speak about the future of our time. Gathers regarding the orders of which are low public, and I see you have come here on great numbers, under the very nonsense of our present leaders. They want to keep us shut up in our houses, in our fears, with a pretext of a mystery sickness regarding among us. They want to restrain us from formulating grievances, from forming groups. They want to isolate us and thus make us powerless. They want to make us easy prey for their disease. This is for their invention. It is to hide the real reason behind this appearance and those deaths. This death, Padre Mikel, is political. We are playing right into the hands of our oppressors. There has been a masterful evil plot working in our midst. Some of you will protest my theory, saying that those counselors could not have been murdered by orders of the others. Those who remain with the administration entirely with the power of the government on hands and foot. We must look to benefit from all those deaths.
What can we do?
Tell us what to do!
Revolt, terrorism, violence! Let's kill all the ones who are complicit with this regime!
Many of them have no choice but to follow the captain's orders for their fear for their families. Many of them die too!
It is better for people today. It is better for people today to screw those tyrants! And fight for our children! For our children's children! For the freedom of our lives and our country! Because no one! No one! It's innocent in war.
Where's the evidence?
Here, sir!
Can you bring it to me? Do you not have a job to do?
Yes, sir!
Prisoners.
Not. No! No! You killed her!
the heck is this? Let me press these motherfuckers before you come bothering me.
Yes, my captain.
Tell everyone they died of the disease.
Your job is to clean this place up. Now.
When the forest was young, it was home to many creatures who were full of magic and wonder. At the heart of this forest stood a colossal fig tree. The forest folk slept in the shadow. But the tree is dying. Its branches are dry, its trunk old and twisted. A monstrous toad has settled in its roots and won't let the tree thrive. You must put 3 magic rocks in its mouth and retrieve a magical key from its insides. Only then will the fig tree flourish again. I am the daughter of the king of the underworld, and I am not afraid of you.
You have dared to enter my lair without permission. You have prevented me from satisfying my appetite with the pearl box placed within my reach. My vengeance shall reach you and will fall upon that which you hold most.
Aren't you ashamed? Living down here, eating all the pill bugs, and getting fat while that tree dies?
How dare you challenge me? You shall know and feel that the toad is not to be insulted with impunity. How dare you interfere with my supper? I will.
I can see now that you are afraid. A little mouse like me appears beneath these roots, and even a greedy toad can be thrown into panic. Here. Quench your fear on these 3 bright berries I have brought you.
All the fairy tales in the world are nothing. Comparison to a minute of song. When feelings surge and wave, soul feels profoundly and finds itself or goes mad. Tears are the melting of snow, and the crying person's closest to them, escaping the prison they are confined.
Going through all that trouble. We're all prisoners now. And that jail is
a lot more dangerous than this one.
Hey, don't put that stuff with me. You can scare him, maybe. You're wasting your time with me. He gets cold feet sometimes. Not me.
The guards by the gates are dead.
What's that? Who got the guards? Why didn't you get other guards to replace them?
Oh, they've been replaced, all right.
Hey! Are you making fun of us or something?
I don't usually make fun, do I? A war is raging throughout the city, right up to the city walls, which are guarded by men who could die at any moment. And even if they did, the gates would not be open since there are guards posted outside them with orders to keep anyone from leaving.
The city within its limits is enough for me.
There's no hope. People are lying in the streets, gutters, churches, and temples, and the rest have disappeared.
That's it. You're lying. It's an administrative trick. You're lying. You just want to scare us.
Go. See for yourself. But you won't be seeing or hearing for long, I'll tell you that. Yesterday, a trolley started out at one end of the city, full of passengers. They all died. All 87 of them. 88, counting the driver, who died once he reached the end of the line.
Nobody asked to take the trolley.
Here, we're out of danger. Look at how thick these walls are. Nothing can get through here. Here, you're in prison, I'll admit. But you can consider yourself safe and sound. The real prison is outside. So, what will it be? Prison? Or death?
It's not true! He gave me you!
Go, see for yourself!
It's a trap!
Haven't I told you? I've left the door open for you.
What are you going to do?
He's a liar! A tricky liar!
He's not lying.
How do you know that? That any proof?
Last night, I had a dream. I saw bodies, piles of bodies so high they went up higher than the sixth floor buildings. And you see, he did leave the door open.
Nah, you're just a chicken. You're too scared to break out. I'm doing it alone. I gotta do this for mankind. Love and freedom! I'm going through the window. I don't just open doors either.
He won't make it very far.
Help! The rats are attacking me! I can't swim any further! Help! Help!
His swollen body is floating on the water already.
You see? I've told you the truth.
What are you doing? You can't. No, I believed you. No, that you can't.
We're all prisoners. Some of us are in cells with windows, and some of them. The longer we confine ourselves to a place, to a belief, to an idea, the more it confines us. The tyrants keep us in our cells for so long that if we get a chance to escape, we lug them with us on our shoulders, like Sisyphus scaling the mountain.
Thank you.
the men in the woods, weren't you?
Have you told anyone?
No. I don't want anything bad happening to you.
Nor me to you.
Do you know the lullaby my mother sang? Yes?
I do.
I want to hear it.
Suffering is to forgive.
Farewell, my dear one. My beloved mother, my good father, you were the first rays of sunshine that ever warmed my life. I did not know how to preserve this warmth. I left without so much as casting a backward glance. I was so filled with illusions about the future that I did not understand the happiness I was abandoning, in which I would never recover. Please, take care of each other, as I know you are the last remaining members of my family. I am so happy that you managed to escape this blood-soaked land of ours. I hope you understand that I had to stay and fight. My only regret is that I will never see you again. Perhaps in this war I have sinned too much, but I will make my amends in the morning on the final battlefield. I keep hoping that somehow we will be saved, that someone will come to the aid of the survival of our people. Please, do not be tormented by what I have written. I love you so. Goodbye forever. My final thoughts are with you.
See?
Oh, here you are. Do you have what we need?
Yes, as much as could be fair without good news. This is your madness. When Captain finds out about us, have you thought about that?
Are you that afraid of him, Doctor?
It's not here. At least not for myself.
There they are! Hurry!
Everything we could manage. Let's see how that leg is doing.
I think he's doing, Doctor. He's fucked up, right? But I will leave. Won't I?
Of course you'll leave. Look at the sacrifice the doctor and Mercedes have made for you and for all of us.
We will soon have reinforcement. 50 men or more. Then we will go head to head with the captain.
And then what? You kill him, they'll send another one just like him. And then another. You're screwed. No guns, no roof over your heads. You need food, medicine, more than we can bring you. If you were your lover, Sadie's, you would cross with her. This is the last cause.
There's no choice, Doctor. We'll stay here.
Pedro, here's my copy of the key. But don't use it now. It's what he wants. I'm a coward.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
I'm a coward for living with that son of a bitch. For making his bed, for making him food, for watching as he kills our people. What if they're right? What if we can't win?
Well, at least we will make things harder for that bastard. He useless man.
Are you coming to the tree? A dead man called out, orders love to flee. Strange things have happened here, no stranger would it be. We met at midnight in the hanging tree. Are you coming to the tree? When told you to fight, so be it all be free. Strange things have happened here.
That is me, and the girl is you.
And the baby?
I see that you got the key from the toad. Your little fairy is very glad you succeeded. She's believed in you from the start. Keep the key, you'll be needing it. And also this, a piece of chalk. You have 2 tasks left to fulfill before the moon is full. Be patient. We'll soon be strolling through the 7 circular gardens of your palace.
And how do I know that what you say is true?
Why would a poor little fool like me lie to you? The time is night. You must meet your second task.
But my mother is sick.
That is no excuse for negligence! Look! This is a magic root. A plant that dreamt of being human. Each morning give it 2 drops of blood. Now, we have no time to waste. Let my pets guide you through. You're going to a very dangerous place, so be careful. The thing that slumbers there. It's not human either. You see a sumptuous banquet, but do not eat or drink anything. Your life depends on it.
Use the chalk to trace a door anywhere in your room. Open it and start the hourglass. Let the fairies guide you. Don't eat or drink anything and come back to the lights for a sample through. Now turn the hourglass quickly. We must find the lock and turn the key. There's a lock. It's this one. No. It's this one. That's not it.
How about this one?
Without suffering any punishment. I am here because I want a clean new world order because people like you believe they are worthy of far more than I care to allow. The punishment for your bravado is to be devoured, and I am intent on my pound of flesh, and that is that.
Captain!
It's a little stale, don't you think? How about we make it more interesting?
I'll make you a deal. If you can count to three without spewing any rhetoric out of your foul mouth, you can leave. I mean, look at me. There is no one above me! Garces, if I say this asshole can leave...
Then he can leave, Captain. You are certainly a man of your word. I'll even have the doctor be brought in case she may be needed. Shall we count to three together?
One.
Oh.
Two.
Extraordinary effort and self-control.
Three, you fucking bastard! Long live the revolution!
I believed in you. It's a pity. Now it's time for my friend to do his job, and you will tell me everything I need to know. Circumstances, nothing would ever be achieved. Now, I do understand the feelings of those who wish things may have been done differently. We all may wish that, but who says that politics is the art of the possible? It is just a game. The trick is in convincing everyone that their palace is a prison, and their prison is a palace. And that's what we politicians are really good at.
I'm sorry. I don't want to be an emperor. It's not my business. I don't want to rule or conquer anyone. I should like to help everyone. It's possible. Greed has poisoned human souls, has barricaded a world with hate, has gusted us into misery and bloodshed. We think too much and feel too little. Without humanity, life will be violent and all will be lost. Don't give yourself to Buddhists. Men who despise you, enslave you, who regiment your lives, who tell you what to do, what to feel, what to think. Let us fight for a free world. To do away with national barriers, to do away with greed, with hate, with intolerance. Let us fight for a world of reason, a world where science and progress we lead to all men and women happiness. In the name of democracy,
in the name of democracy! Let us unite.
Are you done with your nonsense?
Shut the
gypsies. And I was happy because they pilfered. Then they came to take the Jews. I said nothing because they were unpleasant. Then they came to take the homosexuals. And I was relieved because they were annoying. Then they came to take the communists. I said nothing because I am not a communist. Then one day they came to take me. And there was no one left to protest.
The rebel spoke of an informant here, right inside my own home. Can you imagine that? Right under my nose, Mercedes. Please tell me, my dear young lady. You must think me a monster.
You always thought I was invisible. That's how I was able to get away with it.
You found my weakness. Arrogance. How perceptive. You're gonna talk, and I will have to believe that everything you tell me is true. But at first, I wouldn't be able to trust you.
I'm not afraid of you. Don't you see? Look how strong I am. I knocked you down with the flick of a finger. I'm not afraid of you. I need to understand why. Ugh. Tell me why! You stopped me from being happy. You stopped a great deal of many more. I suppose you don't believe in happiness. Ugh. You think happiness is impossible in this world? I suppose you never thought for a second you were wrong. You were so sure you were right!
Ah! Ah!
You hurt me personally. In the worst way possible. Destroying everything. Perhaps you think the human race is rotten in itself. You want to punish the human race? Answer me! Or perhaps you killed all those people out of kindness. To save them from suffering.
What if I did?
For you, life is just suffering. You want to cure people of the haunting fear of death. But death is now looming on your doorstep!
That's all. It's the last task.
Harry, you promised you're gonna do it, so give me the boy. I wanna leave this place and I can't wait any longer.
No. My brother stays with me.
You give up your sacred rights for this brat?
Yes.
You would give up your throne for him? He who caused you such misery, caused you your mother such humiliation?
I will.
As you wish, Your Highness.
Ophelia! Give me my son.
No! Time, you could not speak, you could not breathe, we were all threatened. We had to escape from here. We didn't use the word exodus, but that's what it was. The truth is that it was La Retirada. In school, we're told that Guernica was bombed by Basque separatists themselves. That is the news we have to swallow as kids. That is, until we learn the truth. And now we're expected to forgive? To forget? They implemented the Pact del Olvido, the Pact of Forgetting, so that those behind the disappearances of people, of our people, could be absolved and never be held accountable for their actions. We are told by our leaders that there is no use in looking back, but only moving forward. And even in the reparations that have been promised, very little of the past has been dug up. Our family's bones still lay in mass unmarked graves. They will never be absolved.
Captain! Captain! Captain, come quickly. Our guards have been overrun by the rebels.
How many are there? What happened?
I don't know, sir. The shots came from all around us.
How many men do we have left?
20, maybe even less.
Put the remaining men on picket duty at the tree line. When another squad gets back, call for reinforcement. I said, come for it! My son. Tell him. Tell him about his father. Tell him about when his father died. Tell him!
No. He won't even know your name.
It's for my people. For all our people in our town.
Princess returned to her father's kingdom, and that she reigned with justice and a kind heart for many centuries. And she was loved by all of her subjects. And like most of us, she would leave small traces of her time on earth, visible only to those who knew where to look. But we must be careful here. Fascism and tyranny grow like weeds and can choke the beauty and life from this world. Especially when we're angry, afraid, confused. We may be more tempted to give away bits of our freedom, or less painfully, somebody else's. in the quest for order and direction. In these moments, many of us no longer want to be asked, what do you think? Instead, we want to be told where to march. That's when fascism gets its start, when other options don't seem enough.